In this video, we will implement Firefly algorithm using Python. What is this algorithm, how it works, its mathematical models, and step-by-step explanation using numerical example. We already discussed in previous videos. For more details, you can check these videos. So right now you can see the simple steps they are followed in this algorithm. So here we will use these simple steps to implement this algorithm. First, you will define the objective function, initialize population, define gamma, then the main loop for this algorithm started here. Then we will update the firefly's position in the search space based on the light intensity and the attractiveness values. After that, we will again evaluate the new solution and then rank the fireflies, find the best solution, repeat the loop until the stopping criteria is met. And once the stopping condition is met, again, rank the fireflies and return the best solution. First, we will import here the important library, that is NumPy as np. After that, we will define the objective function. Here, we are using simple benchmark test function. You can define different objective function according to your optimization problem. So we're using this simple sphere function and we will select the minimum value. So we're doing here the minimization. You can define your own objective function according to your optimization problem. After that, we'll define the Firefly algorithm. Before that, first we will initialize the parameters. First, we will initialize the parameters for the objective function. For this objective function, we have dimension, suppose 3, lower bound, minus 5, upper bound, that is 5. After that, we have different Firefly algorithm parameters. Population size, we are taking here 50, that is the total number of search agents. Maximum number of iterations, we have 100. Light absorption coefficient, that is gamma, is equal to 1. Traction coefficient, beta, that is 1. Mutation coefficient, alpha, that is 0.1. Damping ratio, alpha damp, that is 0.95. Now all the parameters are initialized. Now we'll define the Firefly algorithm. So here we'll define the main function for this algorithm. We have Firefly. Inside this function, we'll take all the parameters, that is for the objective function and the algorithm parameters. So we have objective function that we are using here, lower bound, upper bound, dimension, maximum number of iterations, population size. Then we have algorithm parameters, gamma 1, beta, that is 2, alpha 0.2, alpha damp, that is 0.98. So first we will initialize the best solution. So here we have the best solution, that is equal to it having position and cost. So position, so initially position is set to none and the cost is infinity, that is a positive infinity. Next, we will store the best fitness value in an array. So here we will use one array to store best cost, that is the best fitness value in each iteration. So we have np.zeros, so it is filled with zeros, and here using this we will store the best cost found. Next, we will initialize the firefly's population. So here we'll initialize the population of fireflies using array to represent the firefly's current position in the search space and the cost. So we have position, that is np.random.uniform. So all the fireflies are randomly distributed in the search space within the boundary, that is lower bound, upper bound, and the cost of the firefly's position. Initially we have none. After that, we will calculate the fitness values. So initially you can see the cost is none. Now we will calculate the fitness value. for each search agent. So here first you will create a loop that will iterate through each Firefly in the population. So we're using the objective function to calculate the fitness value for each Firefly current position and store it. Now we will check if any Firefly has infinite cost. In case if you're getting the infinity value, you can check your objective function whether there is some error in the declaration, or there you can check here, or you can check the initial range of the variables. If we have infinite cost, then it will display a message that the solution have infinite cost, and it will return the best solution and the best cost. Now the main loop for this algorithm started. So first you will create a loop that will iterate for the maximum time. So here we have max t, that is the maximum number of iterations. Next we will initialize new population. So here we'll store the updated Fireflies in each iteration in new population. So here initially the position is none, cost is none, so we are storing the updated Fireflies in each iteration. Now we will create a nested loop that will iterate through each Firefly I and compare it to all other Fireflies J in the population. So here we will compare J Firefly cost with the I Firefly cost. So we will compare Fireflies to check if the Firefly J is brighter than the Firefly I. So we will do this comparison based on their fitness value. After that we will calculate the distance between their position. So here we are using this equation to find out the distance between the Fireflies, to find out the distance between two Fireflies located at location xi and xj. Xi and xj, so we had two Fireflies. So we have Firefly I position and Firefly j position. Then we have beta, that is the attractiveness function of the Firefly. We will calculate this value using this equation. So here we will calculate the attractiveness of Firefly j to I based on the distance, and the attractiveness difference. So here we have a coefficient parameter, that is beta naught and gamma. Then we are using the distance here that we calculated before. Next we have the movement vector, that is E. For this is used for the exploration that is generated, within the search space boundaries. So here we have all the boundaries dimension. Now we will create new solution. So we'll calculate the new position of the Firefly I based on the attractiveness towards Firefly J and random movement vector E. So we calculated the new position for the Fireflies, but we need the new position within the search space boundary. So now we will check whether the new position is within the bounds or not. So we have two bounds, lower bound and upper bound. So we will check the new solution position and p dot maximum new solution, and then we will check for the minimum, so we need the value within the lower bound and the upper bound, so the value should not exceed. After that we will calculate the fitness value of new position that we calculated for the Fireflies. So we'll apply the objective function again on the new solution and find out their fitness values. So when the fitness value is calculated, now we have the new solution and the older solution. Now we'll check if the new solutions are better than the older one or not. So here we'll compare if the new position improves the fitness of the Fireflies. If it is better, then we will update the position and the fitness value for the fireflies. So first we will check if the updated firefly, that is the new solution cost, is better than the older firefly cost. After that, further we will compare this with the current best solution. So I will compare the firefly with the current best solution, whether the new solution is better than the current best or not. If it is so, then we will consider that as the new best solution. So here we will copy this. Comparison is done. Now we will do the replacement of each firefly in new population. So we'll copy the updated firefly I to new population from replacement. So here you can see the new population is copied. Firefly I copy. So we copy the new population is copied here from the current population. It is now copied. Now we'll merge the current firefly population with the newly generated population. So in case if the firefly gone outside of the search space, so we'll filter out any individual with none cost, then sort the merged population based on their cost. We will give the lower index to the fitter solution because we're doing here the minimization now. So we will sort and combine them by cost. So now we'll take only the top individuals with the lower cost from the population. We will only take the individuals with the lower cost, that is on the top. We'll sort the population based on the fitness values again. So again we'll sort the firefly list to check whether the best solutions are at the beginning or not. So here we sort the population and we will check based on the cost, that is the fitness value. Now we'll calculate mutation coefficient alpha. The damping is used here to reduce the randomness in the movement of the fireflies. Now we will store the best solution. Finally, we will display the solution. We will print here the iteration number and the best cost. We will display here the final best solution that is found in the current iteration. So when the loop is stopped, we will display the best solution. Above, we will display the best solution iteration wise. In this case, we will display the current best solution that is found overall, including its position and the cost, that is the fitness value. So now we'll run firefly algorithm. For this again we will call the function. So this function will return, so we need best solution, position and the best cost, that is the fitness value, as the output. So here we are calling this function that we already declared above. So here all the parameters inside this function. And in the end, we will display the best solution and its fitness value. So print best solution. So print best solution position and the fitness value. And we'll print the best solution fitness value. Run the code and here we find out one error. Here we have exp. Again run the code. Again we have one error. So here we have one error, that copy bracket. Now it will copy. Now you can see it's running. No, it's breaking. Okay. So here you can see the solution. In each iteration, it is improving. You can see we're doing the minimization. So in each iteration, we're getting the better solution. Clear the space, run again. And you can see for 100 iteration, we obtain the solution with the fitness value and the position. And in each iteration, you can see the solution is improving. That's what we need. So maximum you can do 15 or 30 run, and then you can check when the solution is repeating itself. When the final solution start repeating itself after a certain run, it means that is the best solution. So now you can see the code is working. So we are doing this for the simple function. You can use here, you can define your own objective function and then run the code. You can change the number of population size or other parameters you can adjust. Now you can see population size, we have 100. You can see when the population size is 100, there is slight change in the final result. So every time you run the code, your randomness will generate different results. So maximum we can do 15 to 30 run, and when the solution start repeating itself, it means that is the best solution. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.